Friday, we had the majority of the team really buy into the compete level that we addressed after Penn State. But I think it was even better Saturday night. You know, Saturday night, I felt it was 100%. You know, that we did a lot of little things really well. We blocked a ton of shots. We went to the net hard. I think we were first to touch, you know, on the forecheck a number of times. And as a result, we were able to build a 3-0 lead. Got a little bit chaotic there in the third period, you know, late especially. But that, you know, more credit to UMass. They did a good job of generating opportunities against us. And we had a little bit of panic going on. But I thought, as I said after the game, Mr. Hoffman did a great job of getting back to playing, you know, his best hockey, you know, both Friday and Saturday. So that was a good sign for us that he's got his confidence back. And, you know, again, I think our team's starting to understand what it takes to be successful, or at least give ourselves a chance to be successful. And that's large in part due to how we practice right now.
You can't be satisfied with what we did this past weekend. Sure, we picked up a win, but we also picked up a loss. So you just got to go in with the same mentality every time, and knowing that if you work hard throughout the week in practice, good things will happen.
We at least give ourselves a chance to win hockey games when we play like that. Like, we have to have that level of competitiveness and execution, for that matter, just to give ourselves a chance. We've said all along we're a team that has some, you know, has some offensive ability. We have to do it a certain way. We have to score goals a certain way, and that's, you know, getting bodies to the net and crash and bang. It's not always going to be the pretty goals. But more importantly, we have to play a great team game. We're not a team that has two lines that can carry the rest of the guys because they're having an off night. You know, we have to have, you know, six defensemen, four lines, and a goaltender playing as well as they possibly can to give ourselves a chance to win.
We went into last weekend thinking that it was playoff mentality. We're coming down to, I think we got 10 games left or so. And every game is important. Every game is a conference game. We have to pick up points. The standings are really tight right now, definitely in the bottom four teams. I think we're 1 point behind UMass now for a seventh spot. And we just got to, like I said, go into every weekend with the same mentality that it's a playoff game and we need to get points.
You know what? I'm excited about the opportunity. I think anytime you get on the bus and you head down to Boston College, you better be prepared for a very, very difficult game. Regardless of injuries, regardless of previous outcomes, I think you have to have your A game just to give yourself a chance. They're a great team. You know, they're fortunate to have just an abundance of skill and talent. What happened to them last weekend, you know what, that's over and done with. We're going to expect to see them at their best.
Well, we just got to, I think, go into this weekend with the same mentality that we had coming into last weekend. Like you said, we just got to keep working hard, do the little things right, and just battle against them. They're a team that likes to wheel, and they got a lot of skill and talent. But if we outwork their skill and talent, we should be successful. Definitely in college, I think any team can beat any team. You look at even Division III teams compete Division I teams, and every team has the talent. And like I said, it's not always the best team. It's the team that plays the best on that given night. So we're just, like I said, going in the weekend with a hardworking mentality, and like I said, hopefully we can be successful.